Hello and welcome. I'm Gary Shipe. Thanks for listening in as we continue to talk with leaders in our community. Well, today should be a fun half hour because everybody likes kids, and kids are the focus of our guests. With us today, Ryan Scott, Vice President and COO of the Bellevue Boys and Girls Club, and Nathalie Cruz, a club member there. Ryan and Nathalie, welcome. Thanks for coming today.
Thanks for having us. We're thrilled to be here.
Ryan, the Bellevue Boys and Girls Club, it's part of the Boys and Girls Clubs of America, right? A national organization that's, it's like 100 years old, isn't it?
More than 100 years.
More than 100 years, yeah. And Bellevue, there's been a clubs in Bellevue for not 100 years, but...
Well, pretty close, about over 60 years. We were founded in 1952.
Wow.
And have been in the community since then, serving kids and trying to provide great programs. So we've been around for a long time.
And I don't know, you're not nearly old enough to know the the reason why it started, except that maybe you've read about it. What was the genesis of a boy, and back then it was a boys club,
yeah,
right?
Indeed.
A boys club nationally, and then even the Bellevue Boys Club. When that started, what was the reason why, you know, people got together and said, we need a boys club or ought to have one?
Yeah, great question. Interestingly enough, it really started around athletics. And in this case, it was a judo program that had been running in the program, that had been running in the community for a number of years. And that was kind of the first organized program around the Boys and Girls Club here in Bellevue. And from there, it, you know, different programs kind of added on to it and has evolved into what it is today, which is a lot of different things, really. We're a little unique in the way of Boys and Girls Clubs in that we start at 2.5 and go all the way up to 18 and provide programs from preschool age to elementary and middle school all the way up to teens. So we've got quite a wide range of things that we're offering today.
2.5-year-olds, no kidding.
2.5-year-olds, yeah. They're an interesting group. They're a lot of fun to have in the mornings for our preschool program.
And do they do judo?
They do not do judo, no.
Is judo still offered?
Judo is still offered, yeah.
Nathalie, do you do any judo at the Boys and Girls Clubs?
No.
Oh.
No judo.
Let me ask you, so how long have you been going? You're a high schooler, right?
Mm-hmm.
How long have you been going to a Boys and Girls Club?
Well, I started going at 5 years old, so about 13, maybe?
Wow. So,
no.
Yeah, 12 or 13 years you've been going, and so there's more than one, right? I mean, when you say Bellevue Boys and Girls Club, mm-hmm. it's not just a building. There's several all around the east side, right?
Yep, we have 13 sites in Bellevue, and we're spread. You know, our footprint is pretty big. Actually, we're spread all around. We've got a couple of kind of big clubhouse areas that we work out of. One in downtown Bellevue, one in Eastgate. We have a presence in the Crossroads Community Center, but then we've also been a little bit strategic about getting out into elementary schools and public housing sites in Bellevue. So we've kind of planted our programs in communities where we know there's a real need.
So you have something, if not a full, what you call a clubhouse, on a location where it could really serve the community. A low-income housing area?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got 3 sites in public housing, which we've got a great partnership with King County Housing Authority and have been there for about 15 years. And then Bellevue School District, another great partner of ours, we've had sites on elementary school campuses now for a little over, well, about the same time, about 15 years. So,
and that leads me back to the question of the why. What's the mission? Has the mission changed over the 100 years and over the 60 years you've been here on the east side?
I don't think the mission's changed a whole lot. I mean, really, at the very base level, I mean, we're there to provide a positive, safe, engaging place for kids to be after school, during weekends, during school's outbreaks. And that still continues to ring very true for us. I think for Bellevue, one of the interesting things that we found is that, you know, really we needed to be out in different parts of the community because it can be difficult to get to programs. And, you know, instead of trying to build a giant clubhouse and have kids and families come to us, we kind of made the conscious decision where we're going to go out to where they are and make sure that it's accessible and easy to get to and engaging and safe and fun.
And Nathalie, so how, since a 5-year-old, how have you gotten to the Boys and Girls Club? I mean, is there one within walking distance of where you've lived?
Yeah, well, when we first moved here, we lived in Spearwood Manor, which is one of the housing sites. And we just found the Boys and Girls Club, and we just joined it because my mom worked. So we needed somewhere to go, as well as just getting resources that we need because we struggled coming here. So, yeah, it was really helpful.
So that sounds like that is the the reason. I mean, so that kids and families can count on a place where they don't have to worry about the struggles. They can find a place after school to grow, I guess.
Absolutely. Yeah. And that takes, you know, a number of different forms, whether it be an after-school program or a preschool program or athletics or teen drop-in program. We try to provide something that really works for, you know, for each family.
Well, I wanted to ask this before we get into more specific things, going back to the genesis of it. It was boys clubs for the longest time, right? How long has it been a boys and girls club?
It's a great question. We actually are very proud to say that we were one of the first clubs in the country to allow girls to come in, because traditionally it was a boys club. And about in mid-1970s, 1974 or so, we changed our name to Boys and Girls Clubs and started running girls programs at the same time. And over the years, you know, the national organization has followed, but much later into the early 90s. And so we see ourselves as a little bit of a pioneer on girls programming in that respect.
And so now I want to talk about that. So as you talk about looking ahead and forward thinking, what kind of programs do you offer? I don't know, what kind of things attracted you over the years that you've been there? More than 10 years you've been going as a little kid. Mm-hmm. Now you're a high school, what, a junior, right?
Yeah.
So there must be different things that have appealed to you over the years. Have there been favorite programs that you found? And Ryan, I'll ask you after she's done, maybe that have always applied and that are always popular, or things you always try and find something new. What's going on at a typical boys and girls club that makes people want to come back?
Well, I remember being really interested in Smart Girls, because we did a lot of activities where we talked about things we were growing through, like whether it was puberty or boys or trying to, like, our bodies, like just changing, getting help from that. And we had a lot of fun field trips too. So it was really fun. I really liked it. At our club right now, there's one for younger kids, the 6th and 7th graders, and then we used to have one for the older kids, but
Smart Girls, is that what you called it?
Smart Girls.
So you're a smart girl.
Yes.
That's just not bragging. You're in a club called Smart Girls. Mm-hmm. Okay, how about athletics now? They have traditionally offered a lot of athletics. You didn't play judo, you didn't do any judo, but
no judo.
Were you ever attracted as a youngster to, or maybe when you got to middle school, kids start, yes, a lot of kids play soccer, get on a basketball or a volleyball team. Did you like any of those or not?
Well, me, no, but I know they provide like basketball at the main club in downtown Bellevue. But me personally, I wasn't really into sports. I was into dancing, and they did do some talent shows.
No kidding.
Yeah, and we loved going. We won like every year. Spiritwood. We dominated.
Talent show. That's something I wouldn't have thought of as a program or as something offered.
Well, you know, I think, you know, Nathalie kind of hit it, that the active, you know, being active is a real priority for us. And you know, you have the organized athletics, and we have. You know, we have one of the largest athletic programs for a boys and girls club in the country, about 5,000 kids who play with us every year. But then, you know, within our clubs for those kids who aren't participating in the structured athletics, we still want to provide activities like dance and talent shows that get kids up and moving, because, you know, it's an important part of every day. And we want to make sure that, you know, we're instilling healthy habits that, you know, that include, you know, physical activity, and if talent shows and dance is the way to engage kids, then absolutely we're gonna be right there.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. And you know, while I was talking and asking my question about soccer and et cetera, I mean, a lot of parents get kids, or at least try to get them interested in some kind of athletic, and often it's soccer. Does the Boys and Girls Club join some of the leagues that are? I mean, is there a Boys and Girls Club team that is in some of those leagues?
Well, we actually run our own league because.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Well, it's interesting. Bellevue really doesn't have a lot of options outside of us. There are no sports options in the Bellevue School District up until the high school level.
Really?
Yeah. And so they, because of that, they really all kind of funnel through the club. So when I say 5,000 kids, we'll have our own basketball league, we'll have our own football league, we'll have our own soccer. You know, we do baseball, we do most of the traditional sports, and then we do have some of those other ones that maybe aren't seen as traditional. Your judo, taekwondo, we're actually running a parkour class right now. Gymnastics.
Is that the sport where you sort of run and hop and
yeah, you
flip
jump off
yourself?
Buildings.
Okay,
exactly.
I didn't know that
What's
could be
cooler
taught.
Than flipping off things, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Especially if you're a 9-year-old,
indeed.
I guess.
Yeah.
Do you get a little padded room to practice that on?
Yeah,
you
yeah,
must
we,
fall
we,
down
yes.
a lot when you learn that.
Yes, we do. So.
Good. Well, how about some others? Now, you mentioned Smart Girls as mm-hmm. more of a club. Like, it sounds more like a... probably off a group therapy, but I don't know what.
Well, kind of, yeah.
Are there other clubs like that where you just get together with a single idea or a focus, and you know, like school, or parts aspects of school? I mean, science or chemistry, or do they have things like that?
Well, we have the Be Great Graduate program where
be a great graduate.
Be great graduate.
Okay.
Yeah. And we just they make sure we're getting our homework done. They give us like. They provide tutors sometimes, and they just help us maintain our high grades and get the information we need for college.
Aha.
Mm-hmm. And there's the Keystone Club, which I'm a part of. I'm the vice president, and we do community service around the community, and we run this cafe or store mm-hmm. inside of the club so kids can buy their treats or whatever, so we can... raise money to go to the national conference.
Wow, Keystone Club. So you're instilling in them already a sense of community, give back. I mean, that must be the mm-hmm. mission of that Keystone Club, a community service organization?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, really the goal is to show, you know, teens that they can have an impact in their own community. And, you know, one of the ways to do that is to really get them out and have them be part of community service projects. And I think the cool, you know, one of the cool things about this program is that a lot of times you have kids who engage in that that are not traditionally your ASB presidents or your, you know, captain of a sports team, that they have some leadership opportunities that are a little bit different and may not traditionally jump on in the school you know kind of area. And so for us to be able to provide something and get them out and get them engaged is really fun.
Wonderful. We're talking with Ryan Scott and Nathalie Cruz of the Bellevue Boys and Girls Clubs this morning. Before I get to a little more narrow touch of today's talk, I want to make sure I ask this. Does it cost something to go to the Boys and Girls? It must not cost much if it costs something, right?
Yeah. No.
I mean, when people say a club, when you join a club, you usually have to pay some dues. Is that a typical thing? Are there dues to this club or membership fees?
There are. For some of our programs, there are. I would say about half of our mm-hmm. programs. For example, some of our sites in public housing, our teen sites, there's no program fees attached to it. So mm-hmm. we really don't want that to be a barrier for anybody having to try and access our programs. We do have some program fees around some of our structured athletic programs. Some of our after-school programs, but we try and keep those very minimal. And, you know, one of the things that we feel very strongly about is that, you know, we won't turn a family away because they're unable to pay financially. That shouldn't be a barrier. So, you know, last year we awarded about $800,000 in scholarships just to make sure that, you know, the kids in our community were able to access the programs that they needed to support. So, you know, so
awesome.
it helps us with some of the athletics to be able to charge some minimal program fees, but certainly we
you're just going to pay for ball fields and balls and bats themselves,
indeed.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
But you are a nonprofit, right? I guess
yeah.
I didn't mention that, right?
It's correct. We are a nonprofit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And matter of fact, before I forget this, people can look you up on the web when they have more questions and where all these different clubhouses are. It's bgcbellevue.org, right? And that people can remember that. BGC Boys Girls Club, right? bgcbellevue.org. And even there's a national, the Boys and Girls Clubs of America has their own national website, right? BGCA.org. That one is big picture thing about what the Boys and Girls Club do all over the country, right?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. We're part of a network of about 4,000 clubs around the country. So,
well, Nathalie, this week is midwinter break, right, mm-hmm. for schools, at least on the east side. And it's good to have a vacation once in a while. But are you going to the Boys and Girls Clubs throughout the week? Or at least I know on Wednesday... you guys are hosting a workshop, right? This is an all-day thing called Tech Girls Rock, right?
Yes.
You know, it's all about encouraging women, girls, females, you know, would you say 2.5 to 18? So all of that, girls and women, I mean, when you're 18, I think you're a woman. Take interest in technology and technological side of things, right? I mean, what are we going to – let's talk more specifically about Tech Girls Rock and what that is supposed to be and what it'll actually turn out to be like.
Sure. We're very excited. The Tech Girls Rock program is a one-day workshop designed to really look engage kind of your older elementary and middle school girls, mm-hmm. And really give them an idea of what are the careers out there that are related to technology that might be interesting. And, we know we live in a very tech-savvy part of the world, much
Absolutely.
More than a lot of other, parts of the United States. And I think it's important to be able to show, here are some of the interesting careers that you may not have thought about that are related to technology, and here is the career path that you might think about in order to explore some of those.
Also, it's kind of like a career day with a tech bent to it. Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very much so.
Yeah. So will we have representatives from some of the local tech companies there, encouraging women, and maybe even hopefully women spokesmen, giving them the idea, I did this, you can do this?
Indeed, yeah. We have a series of speakers, particularly in the morning for this workshop, that will be leaders in different technology industries. They may be in web design, they may be in IT support, they may be in social marketing and media, which has become, obviously a big industry over the last 10 years. And it will be a chance for our girls to interact with them, talk a little bit about how they found themselves in the positions that they're in, and ask some specific questions about that will hopefully give them a better idea of what that career might look like.
Nathalie, you got any, you're still young, but any goals mm-hmm. about a career in mind yet? Or do you like to go to and see opportunities like this, say, gee, I didn't even thought about that or so? What do you look for when you go to a workshop like this?
Yeah, I'm not sure what I want to do, but I know this workshop will actually... I can benefit from this because I'm just going to be a volunteer there. But I feel like I don't know a lot about technology careers, and this will be a good opportunity to learn more about them.
Are there things about, engineering, science, computers that our society has said girls need not apply? Is that the reason we have to have a Tech Girls Rock seminar or workshop?
Well, I think there are some technology-related careers that have traditionally been dominated by, for the most part, male-dominated careers. And so I think, one of the real things that we're focusing on as a Boys and Girls Club this year, particularly with our after-school program, is making sure that, all of our kids, but particularly girls, have access to science, technology, math, and engineering programs that, we found that both nationally and locally, there are not enough people coming out of high school and college with those skills for the number of tech jobs that exist even in our area. And so, as you look at it on a big picture, we see that as we can be a real contributor in helping, foster some more interest and some more participation in fields that traditionally may have been male dominated. Mm. On the local level, we think it's a great way for us to get our girls involved in something that's going to be very fun, engaging, interesting, and very much tech related. And and as I said, the technology that exists in this area is
what an opportunity. For
yeah,
people.
Really much
yeah.
so.
Nathalie, I you mentioned was a great graduate before.
Yeah, be great graduate.
Okay, so yeah. As you go to that, and they give you a little counseling to say, if you want to graduate, take this class and this class. If you want to move towards such and such a career, are there, been a long time since I was in high school, digital type of IT type of classes in high school that you can take now I don't even know what classes are offered in high school anymore, that a program like Be a Great Graduate can point you toward and that sort of wraps itself into this Tech Girls Rock
yeah,
workshop?
Yeah, well, Be a Great Graduate encourages you to do whatever you're interested in. I know in Sammamish they provide graphics and computer science classes and a lot of that. So there's a wide variety of different classes you can take at Sammamish, but they just encourage Be Great Graduate staff encourage you to do whatever you want to do, and that's something that I really like.
And so at this Tech Girls workshop, what kind of fields are girls going to be exposed to? IT, meaning information technology. Every company has to have at least one, usually a department that runs their computer and knows how computers work and how information is shared. And and I only use the mouse end of it, you know? So somebody has to know what's going on at the other end. Is that at least one of the things that is offered here?
It sure is. We're partnering with a local company called CA Technologies, and they're actually, you know, have offices all around the company, but or around the country. But, you know, some of the careers they'll be looking at, you know, you're exactly right, IT, engineering. We'll be looking at computer programming. Mm. One of the things that I think our club does really well is we do a lot of work in the way of, you know, particularly game programming. And so our kids get an opportunity to learn some of the basic game programming skills and how to work with that. We'll also be looking at things like, you know, architect, graphic designer, space planner. To your point, there are a lot of careers that require a lot of technology background now. And, you know, being able to provide some mentors that, you know, are currently real world mentors in these fields, I think will be really fun for our girls.
And so I didn't ask this, and we got to make sure we said the when and where. Is it at the main clubhouse in downtown Bellevue?
Yes, mm-hmm. So it'll be our main clubhouse in downtown Bellevue, which is 209 100th Avenue. So on 100th Avenue, just west of the downtown park. And it will be next Wednesday, or this coming Wednesday, February 20th, and we'll run from about 9 a.m. to 5 p.m.
Great. And so I know somebody from this station is going to be there from Movin', one of our stations, just to sort of say hello and say, hey, even radio's got some technical aspects to it. The girls can look. I mean, is that a part of looking up to people, being a I don't know if everybody's a mentor, but at least a role model, I guess, is the phrase I was looking for. Is that a important part of this kind of a workshop too?
Oh, I think that's a very critical part of it. I think the positive role modeling that happens, you know, every day after school in programs like Boys and Girls Clubs is invaluable. And, you know, I think it's one of those things that can be the motivating factor that gets kids to really explore a career that they may not have thought of before simply because they see somebody that they really look up to and are engaged by. So absolutely. Mm.
Mm. And how about so the technical part of this, and I go to just because I'm in radio and I fiddle with knobs, so and I also then like digital photography and videography. Are those considered some of the fields you ask girls to look at and explore and think there's careers here?
Absolutely. I think anything that's technology related, but particularly to, you know, as you said, I think those are, you know, fields that will continue to be very strong. And there's going to be a lot of need moving forward for skilled people to be in those careers. And so anything that we can do to turn people onto those and get them excited and interested is a real win.
I'm thinking then that the self-esteem must be one of the characteristics you hope grows in kids at a Boys and Girls Club, and that workshops like this are part of the way to encourage that and bring out what self-esteem means and self-confidence. And I mean, just the pointing out, hey, here's an opportunity, just exposure to a future can grow. Have you found that to be true? I mean, as your years at going to the clubs, say, gee, there's more out there than I thought. Is do they offer that?
Yeah. Programs like this really, really like show you that, hey, there's a lot of different variety of careers you can do. It's not just your income doesn't influence like what you want to do. You know, you can do whatever you want if you set your mind to it.
Let me ask, I don't know if you can answer, this is kind of an abstract question. When you come home, you've been going to the Boys and Girls Clubs for many years now. Mm-hmm. How do you feel when you come home from it after you've been there, maybe you went 2-3 days in a row? Is there something about it that says, that puts a smile on your face or a warm feeling inside that, man, that place is good because, or I get this out of it and it's, I don't know, what are the words, or are there words that line up with those feelings and emotions?
Mm-hmm. They've really become my second family since I've been there for so long.
No kidding.
And you have fun, you play games, hang out with friends, get home, help with homework, and you feel like, whoa, like I'm doing really good right now. They help you stay on track and be successful, and it makes me feel really good.
And is that, maybe Ryan knows the answer to this too, is that the staff or is it the other kids that are there that make it feel like you're welcome here and you're wanted here and you grow here? I don't
Oh, I think it's both. I mean, clearly our staff have a huge impact. And if you ask any of our kids why they come to the club, the number one reason is the staff. And they, you know, they're hardworking, they're dedicated, and they're really good at what they do. And they provide, you know, they provide great opportunities for our kids. And we, you know, and they create, I think, an environment that, you know, really allows kids to be, you know, to reach, you know, all of their goals and be the best that they can be. I mean, we've, mm-hmm. you know, we've seen Nathalie and her two sisters grow up in the club, and, you know, her two sisters are now working for us. And, you know, in the next year, I fully expect that Nathalie will follow in their footsteps.
So you, your sisters, and you, not, you said it feels like a second family. Well, now they work there, is that right? Because mm-hmm. they like it so much. Well, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So we're going to run out of time before too long. Now, I want to make sure we mention, so there's Bellevue Boys and Girls Club, part of Boys and Girls Clubs of America. It's 11 or 13
sites in
places.
Bellevue.
So some of them, I don't know, matter if you can mention, but people can look up on, at least online, to find one in wherever is close to them in Bellevue, right? I mean, there's the main one in, you know, on Main Street. Well, it's 100th Avenue,
yep,
right?
We're in downtown Bellevue.
South Bellevue in the Newport area.
Yeah, over in the
right?
East Gate
Crossroads area.
Crossroads area, Lake Hills area.
A lot of the schools, right?
Yeah, Bennett, Cherry Crest, mm-hmm. Phantom Lake area. We really do have clubs all over the city, and the idea is that we're going to be somewhere near your neighborhood.
Right, so people should take the time then to say, well, this sounds cool. It sounds like Nathalie here is, loves it. My kid ought to love it. So there's probably one near enough to them that they can find it, right?
I would think,
Bellevue.
Yeah.
Again, so I would encourage people, bgcbellevue.org, right? Bellevue, that's Boys Girls Club Bellevue, bgcbellevue.org?
Correct.
Okay, great. And the girl Tech Girls Rock, that's this Wednesday the 20th at the one on 100th, the main clubhouse. All day, really, right?
Yeah, all day. We'll start about 9 and run through to about 5 p.m.
Okay, so before we run out of time, now, what did I forget to ask, or what is there something that you always make sure you tell people that I didn't bring up a topic about Boys and Girls Club? What do you want to say a second time about Boys and Girls Club of Bellevue?
I think the great thing about our organization is that we, you know, the depth and breadth of the programs that we provide, we really have something for, you know, for everyone in the community. Whether you have a preschooler that needs somewhere to be for enrichment, whether you need somewhere to be after school, you know, athletics, teens, you know, we really try very hard to make sure that, you know, that we've got programs that really fit the needs in the community. And to your point, that we're located in the right places so that, you know, it's easy and convenient to get to the club. So,
yeah.
You know, I would encourage everyone to, you know, to come around the corner and hopefully there's a club nearby you and come in and visit and see us.
Nathalie, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
What did you think of, Boys and Girls Clubs, this workshop, but that you have these things like all the time, right?
Yeah.
And so has there been one that you've thought of over the years that, oh, I really loved the one, do that again or something?
Hmm.
Is there a favorite aspect of the Boys and Girls Clubs that you've had that stuck in your mind over the years?
Can't think of a specific one, but all of them were really fun. I liked all of them.
It sounds like what she keeps saying is fun. I mean, she makes
a lot of fun.
She's had fun,
very fun
there,
yes.
But that's not your mission, to have fun. It's really
a big part of our mission.
Yeah, but that comes out of the place you provide.
Yes.
Yeah, but you provide a place. Well, people really is what it is.
Yeah. Well, and you know, and Nathalie has, you know, her and her sisters, they've accomplished some great things. They were featured speakers at our breakfast this past December, and you know, she's being very modest about her accomplishments in the club, whether it be community service. You know, she was telling me as she came in that she's already got almost 300 hours of community service done, and she's looking to try and get 400 done this year.
Wow.
So,
yeah.
You know, she's a real gem, and we're lucky to have her.
What's your favorite like type of community service to do?
Well, during the summer, I'm actually a junior staff at one of the housing sites. The one that my sister works at, I usually go to.
So working with other kids?
Yeah, I really.
Littler kids?
They're so adorable.
Oh,
so
wonderful.
Cute.
Oh, man. So now I'm up against it. We got to another subject. I wish we could keep going, but we are out of time. That sounds cool. I wanted to get into what you like to do. But people can go find that experience themselves at a Boys and Girls Club near them, I guess.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much. We have been talking this morning with Ryan Scott, Vice President, COO of the Bellevue Boys and Girls Club, and Nathalie Cruz, a longtime member at the club and Keystone Club, was it Vice President?
Yeah.
All right. Excellent. And this Wednesday, the Tech Girls Rock on the 20th. So thank you so much for being here. I really enjoyed having you. And really a bigger thanks to what the Bellevue Boys and Girls Club is doing for the kids in our community. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
Mm-hmm. I am Gary Scheib. Thanks for listening today. We hope you've learned something new. Join us again next week as we continue to talk with people that are making a difference in our community.